Hi, this is Damian Carlson from Platform 9. Welcome to the first video in a series covering getting started with Private Cloud Director. This video applies to all versions of Private Cloud Director, whether it's SaaS-managed, self-hosted, or Community Edition, and very closely aligns to what one would experience attending a live hands-on lab session. In this video, we'll cover cluster blueprint creation, onboarding hypervisor hosts, host roles, and more. After logging into the Private Cloud Director web interface for the first time, you'll be presented with a virtualized clusters dashboard. You'll see that we have no virtual machines deployed, no hypervisors, and unused default usage quotas. From here, we choose infrastructure and cluster blueprint from the left navigation menu. The cluster blueprint will be the configuration to create before you can onboard hosts and deploy VMs. This configuration applies to all hosts that have been onboarded to this blueprint, allowing you to express your desired cluster architecture upfront, ensuring that cluster capacity added over time conforms to this desired architecture. Private Cloud Director's cluster resource management provides two critical features that are widely used in the virtualization industry, namely HA and resource rebalancing. VM high availability, or HA, will detect hypervisor host failures and restart the VMs on other hosts in the cluster. Resource rebalancing checks host usage metrics according to the rebalancing frequency and automatically live migrates running VMs to other hosts in the cluster as needed. Next, let's look at cluster networking, which sets the virtual machine networking defaults. The DNS domain name is used to set the fully qualified domain name of virtual machines that are deployed in the cluster. By default, clusters use an internal DNS resolution service, but they can be configured to use external DNS management via a custom configuration. Distributed virtual routing distributes network routing components uniformly across all hosts in the cluster. It's enabled by default and is the recommended configuration for most environments. In order to enable virtual networks for virtual machines, you'll need to choose the desired segmentation technology. Private Cloud Director supports VLANs, VXLANs, or Genevieve. For now, let's keep the defaults. Next, let's look at the host network configurations, which allows you to specify the network characteristics of a group of hosts. We do that by defining one or more network interfaces, optionally assigning them a physical network label, and setting the type of traffic these interfaces will provide. Physical network labels have a couple different uses within Private Cloud Director. One of those uses would be to group differently named network interfaces, such as ETH0 on one host and ENS192 on another host. Physical network labels are also used when creating physical networks within Private Cloud Director, which will be shown later. The management traffic interface is used for administrative tasks like configuration, monitoring, and remote access of the host. This interface will also be used for communication between your SaaS or self-hosted management plane and your hosts. The VM console network interface is used by the Private Cloud Director UI and will use that to load the virtual machine console using the hypervisor's host IP. In most setups, this will generally be the same as your management traffic interface. The image library interface is for disk images that are uploaded to the image library, and it's also used to serve the image contents to the hypervisor when a VM is being provisioned using that image. In most deployments, the image library interface will be the same as the management interface. The virtual network tunnels interface will be used behind the scenes to route traffic when new virtual networks get created. The host liveness check interface is used by the virtual machine high availability service to check if the hypervisor host is up or down. In this lab, each hypervisor host in this cluster has a bonded pair of 10 gig network cards, shown as bond 0. VLANs 3 and 4 in this bond are assigned to private networks in the data center, and VLAN 5 is on a public network. I haven't chosen a traffic type for bond 0.4, as we'll use that interface for our virtual machine physical network. Next up is storage volume types. This is where any volumes attached to a virtual machine will be stored. I've already configured this one for NFS, but Private Cloud Director also provides out-of-the-box configurations for a subset of block storage drivers. If a particular storage driver isn't listed, a custom driver configuration can be entered along with its key value pair. The final cluster configurations are defaults, but they can be changed based on your requirements. I'll save the blueprint and wait for that to complete. Afterwards, I'll begin onboarding my host by clicking Cluster Hosts in the left menu and then clicking the Add New Host button. This page walks through all of the steps necessary to add a new host. You can copy and paste them directly into an SSH terminal on each host. Once the cloud config script is downloaded, I set the configuration that I want to use by declaring the account URL, the username, region, and tenant. I enter the administrator password, choose none for both proxy URL and MFA token, and then begin the host preparation process. This process makes sure that the host is configured correctly and that all required operating system packages are installed. Shortly after the host agent is downloaded and installed, you should see the host pop up in the web UI. Normally, this process takes about 10 minutes, but I've sped it up slightly for the sake of this video. I perform the same steps on the second host and wait for the second host to show up in the UI. Once all of my hosts are in the UI, I can begin setting their roles. Both hosts should use the same network configuration from the cluster blueprint. Both are set as hypervisors. Only one is needed to store the VM image library, and both will use the same NFS storage. The advanced remote support option is for SaaS-managed customers, and the DNS option designates a host as a virtual machine DNS as a service provider. After the host roles are saved, the hosts will go into a converging state as they take on their newly assigned roles. This process normally takes a few minutes. Once all hosts are showing okay, you can begin uploading images and deploying VMs.